pleasant good morning to the brethren, and good morning to our first-time viewers. We are happy to have you here at CREP Pentecostal Empowerment Ministries International. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We continue with our theme, Empowered by His Spirit, Growing to Greatness. And as such, we want to read Romans chapter 8 from verse 15 to 17 and Hebrews chapter 12 from verse 25 to 29. Shall we read together? Romans chapter 8 from verse 15, and it reads, "For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together." And let's look at the second portion of scripture, Hebrews chapter 12, reading from verse 25. "See that ye refuse not him that speaketh. For if they escape not who refused him that spake on earth, much more shall not we escape if we turn away from him that speaketh from heaven. Whose voice then shook the earth, but now he hath promised, saying, Yet once more, I shake not the earth only, but also heaven. And this word, yet once more, signifieth the removing of those things that are shaken, as of things that are made, that those things which cannot be shaken may remain. Wherefore, we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace whereby we may serve God acceptable with reverence and godly fear. For our God is a consuming fire." Thank you, Lord, for your word. Let us pray. Great and mighty God, creator of the ends of the earth, we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. God, there is none like unto you. Who can be compared to you, O God, O King? None in heaven, none in earth, none beneath the earth. So we exalt you, we extol you. God, we commit this morning's service into your hand. Let your name be glorified, God. I pray that you will touch some life today, someone who might be stressed. I pray that you will give them that peace of mind. God, someone who needs healing in their bodies, I pray that you would heal. God, by your stripes we are healed. I pray, God, for someone who might be infected with a virus at this point in time, who really crying out to you, O God. We pray and we believe, God, that you would touch them from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet. Heal, O God, deliver. I pray, O God, for those who need that special touch of deliverance that you would break through in their lives right now, God. We pray for the salvation of men. God, as your word go forth, I pray, O God, they will receive your word. We come against any hindrance of the devil right now. We break down every barrier, every blockage to their salvation right now. Let your word go forth with power and minister unto every hearer today, O God. We lift up, O God, the worship team. Let those songs go forth and minister unto everyone who hears today. We pray in a special way, O God, for the musicians and the technical team. God, let that sound that is produced go forward and minister unto the hearers. Let that song that is produced go forth with excellence, bringing you honor and glory, O God. God, we lift up our nation of Trinidad and Tobago before you. We commit our leaders into your hand, O God. Her Excellency, Paula May, we commit our Prime Minister, the Honourable Dr. Keith Rowley. We commit our opposition leader, the Honourable Kamala Prasad Bisesa. We commit all our parliamentarians into your hand. God, we pray for your protection. We pray that you will cover them. I pray that you will keep them. I pray that you will keep them safe and their families. We commit every parliamentarian into your hand. We pray, God, that as they sit to deliberate, that they would sit and make good laws that would benefit the people of Trinidad and Tobago, God. Minister in a special way unto them, O God. I pray that you would give them the wisdom they need, the understanding they need, God, to lead this nation aright. Send the right advisors their way, O God, as we navigate this pandemic, O God. Give them the right ideas to move forward. Minister in a special way to our Commissioner of Police, Gary Griffith. Give him the wisdom, the understanding, Almighty God, to fight this battle against crime. Minister of Health, we commit into your hand. Wisdom to, oh God, navigate through this pandemic. So we commit all our leaders, we commit this nation into your hand at this time, this trying time. Give us your peace. Provide for those who need, Almighty God. Help us to see those in need and to meet that need. Let your will be done in our nation. Let your will be done this morning in this service, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. At this time, I'd like to welcome our worship team. Please feel free to join us in this time of worship.
Create in me a clean heart and purify me. Purify me, create in me a clean heart so I may worship. Create in me, create in me a clean heart and purify me. Purify me, create in me a clean heart so I may worship thee. Cast me not away from thy presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship thee. Create in me, create in me a clean heart and purify me, purify me. Create in me a clean heart so I may worship thee. Cast me not away from thy presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship thee. Cast me not away from thy presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship thee. Cast me not away from thy presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. And restore the joy of salvation so that I may worship thee.
Hallelujah.
strength. We bow down and worship him now. How great, how awesome is he. We stand up and lift up.
We stand and lift up our hands.
For the joy,
for the joy of the Lord is our strength.
We bow down and worship him now. How great, how awesome is he. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory.
Holy is the Lord
God Almighty. The earth is filled with his glory.
Holy is the Lord
God Almighty. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's a way to measure what you're worth. You were crucified, laid behind a stone. You lived to die, rejected and alone, like a trampled on the ground. You took the form and thought of me. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways. Kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what it's all worth. You were crucified, laid behind a stone. You lived and alone, like a rose, trampled on the ground. You took the form and thought of me. Above all, crucified, lay behind the stone. You lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose, trampled on the ground. You took the form and thought of me. Above all, worthy is the Lamb seated on the throne. We crown you now with many crowns. You reign victorious, high and lifted up, Jesus, Son of God, the treasure of heaven crucified. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy. is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Thank you for the cross. Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the price you paid. Bearing all my sin and shame, in love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for this love, Lord. Thank you. Thank you for the nail pierced hands. Wash me in your cleansing flow. Now all I know, your forgiveness and embrace. Worthy is the Lamb, seated on the throne. Crown you now with many crowns. You reign victorious. The treasure of heaven crucified. Worthy is the Lamb. 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 Hallelujah. He is worthy. Hallelujah. We give you glory. Praise the Lord. Surprise, you've got this figured out. You're watching us now. But when it looks as if we can't win, you wrap us in your arms and step in. And everything we need, you supply. You've got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way. Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test, but holding on,
but holding on to faith you know best.
Nothing can catch you by surprise. You've got this figured out. You're watching us now. But when it looks as if we can't win, you wrap us in your arms and step in. And everything we need, you supply. You got this in control. And now we know that you made a way. When when our backs were against the wall. And it looked
as if it was for
saying,
you made a way.
And we're standing here,
and we're standing here, only because you
say you made a way. When our backs were against
when
the wall,
our backs were against the wall,
and
it looked as if it was over,
you made a way. And we're standing here, only because you've made a way. You move mountains, you cause walls to fall with your power. You perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because
you move
mountains.
You cause
walls to fall with your power. Perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because
you move
mountains.
You cause walls to fall
with your power.
You perform
miracles. There is nothing, my God,
that's impossible.
And we're standing here only because
and we're standing.
And we're standing here only because you made a way. You made a way. Say you made a way. You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
Worship.
Of the word by our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Melch Pope.
Praise the Lord! Hallelujah! What a privilege and an honor that the great I am that I am has given to us again to connect, to commit, and to commune. Hallelujah. Yes, by means of this virtual media platform, we thank God for this privilege. I trust that you're excited about what God is doing in the earth. Yes, the Bible tells us that the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Please stay connected to Him. Talk to Him. I tell you, He's going to lead you in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Remember, I'm glad to be with you again, and I trust that you too are excited at coming to the end of this time, our time together. We will be having communion, so please prepare yourself, the bread and the wine. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. Well, let's get into the precious word of God this morning. I want to thank the many of you who are joining us for the very first time. Thank you for inviting a friend, someone who may be disappointed and discouraged and depressed. Maybe they would have lost their job. And you say, let's go to church. Let's hear. Let's stay there. Let's get in there. Yes, Father, we thank you and we praise you and we honor you today. This is a day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you. Your word commands us to rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. In the midst of all that is happening, Lord, you have a plan and a purpose for every life. And as we connect and commit to you, you are going to make it known to us. So we bless you today. Now, even as we go into your precious word, which is forever settled in heaven, I pray that the knowledge of Jesus Christ will become more and more real to us, and we will continue to grow in grace and in His wisdom, His peace, His anointing, His love for us. Thank you, Father, for ministering. In the name of Jesus the Christ, blessed be His holy name. I want this morning to continue on this aspect of faith, the walk of faith in the life of the believer. We spoke and we've been speaking about our father of faith, Abraham by name. According to Galatians 3:26 to 29, Romans chapter 4 and verse 11 and 16, he is the father of all who believe. Do you believe him today? Do you believe that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and that believing on him we have life through his name? John 20, 30 and 31, do you believe it? Then we need to put it into practice. We need to know that we know that we know that he lives in our hearts. Praise God. So I want to read to you today from Luke the 17th chapter. And we want to seek to answer the question that we've asked ourselves many times. If only I had more faith. God, I want more faith. Give me more faith. Give me more power. Have you ever asked for these virtues? You ask them of the Lord and you say, but why it is and how come, you know, this person is moving on and I am not? Well, let's see if we can answer some of those questions as we go into the precious Word of God, as we continue to walk by faith. You see, because we are empowered by His Spirit. He has enabled us. We are enabled to disable. So we want to be able to see how much we can flow in the realm of the Spirit and of the things of God, so that our lives would continue to be a blessing. Remember, we are the product now, eh? So we are to be a blessing. Luke, the 17th chapter, from the 5th verse. And the apostles, notice, and the apostles said unto the Lord, increase our faith. We want more faith. Verse 6, and the Lord said, if you had faith as a grain of mustard seed, you shall say, or you might say unto the sycamine tree, or mulberry tree, be thou plucked up by the root, and be thou planted in the sea, and it shall obey you. Notice, he says, if you had faith as a grain of mustard seed. I want us to observe that this faith talk. In fact, let me continue to read. Verse 7. But which of you, having a servant plowing or feeding cattle, will say unto him by and by, when he's come from the field, go and sit down to meat, or to eat, or to have supper, or dinner? And will not rather say unto him, make ready wherewith I may sup, and gird thyself, and serve me till I have eaten and drunken, and afterward thou shalt eat and drink? That he thanked that servant because he did the things that were commanded of him, I trow not. Verse 10. So likewise ye, when ye have done all those things which are commanded you, say, we are unprofitable servants. We have done that which was our duty to do. I want us to observe that faith is sandwiched between forgiveness and service, faith, sandwiched between forgiveness and a right relationship. Look at the beginning. Luke, the 17th chapter from the first verse. It is impossible, but that offenses will come. But woe unto him to whom they come. It were better for him for a millstone, if that a millstone were hanged about his neck and he cast into the sea, than that he should offend one of these little ones. Verse 3, take heed to yourselves, if thy brother trespass against thee, rebuke him. And if he repent, forgive him. And if he trespass against thee 7 times in a day, and 7 times in a day, turn again to thee, saying, I repent, you shall forgive him. That's the word of the Lord. You shall forgive him. So faith is sandwiched between forgiveness, the spirit of forgiveness, the spirit of patience and understanding, and a right relationship that has to do with service and sacrifice. Notice what Jesus said concerning forgiveness. And we need not take this for granted. We must forgive. We must be willing to forgive and do it if we are going to continue to walk the faith walk. If we're going to continue to experience God's faith in our lives to do miraculous things, we must be willing to forgive. Remember, a question was asked by Peter in Matthew, the 18th chapter, verses 21 and 22. How often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Till 7 times or till 70 times, you know, how often? Jesus said, I say not unto you until 7 times, but until 70 times 7. So are you going to multiply that 490 times and say, well, you have passed that? Oh, the forgiveness of our God. God so loved that he gave his only begotten son. His forgiveness is inexhaustible, but it is based on the condition that we forgive others. When you stand praying, Jesus said, forgive, Mark the 11th chapter from the 24th verse. When you stand praying, forgive. If you realize that you would have done wrong, then leave. You haven't come to the altar, then leave your gift to the altar and go and reconcile. You see, we want to walk. We want to have plenty of faith. We want to, as it were, manifest the miraculous power of God. But we need to forgive. If he comes, if your brother or your sister comes to you 7 times in the day, in one day, and say, please forgive me, then we must forgive. Very, very important. If we're going to experience the faith life, want more faith, See, what we should really desire is more of God. We want more power. We should desire more of God. I want more grace. We should desire more of God. His grace is always sufficient. The Bible tells us His strength is made perfect in our weaknesses. 2 Corinthians chapter 12 from the 7th verse unto about the 9th verse. So, it's important that we forgive if we're going to have this faith to move mountains. And then Jesus went on to say, okay, if you had faith as a grain of mustard seed. Let's pause there for a while. They tell us that a mustard seed is described as one of the tiniest and most insignificant of seeds in the Middle East. Tiniest, one of, but what is important here, most insignificant. It is like the size of a grain of salt. Yeah? Slightly bigger. Mustard seed. However, when it is sown, into the soil, especially into good ground, in a few months, it can grow up to 10 feet tall. Yes, or taller. Sorry, I'm going beyond myself. Yes, up to 10 feet tall. Got that there. But what I want you to see, what I want us to observe, it is insignificant. And tiny, very, very minute. But once it is sown, once the right things are done to it, sown into soil, once it's been used, once it's been exercised, I'm going somewhere with this, what happens? It grows up to about 10 feet tall in a few months. Oh, blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. You want to talk about your faith? Small? Tiny? What are you doing with it? It must be exercised. Jesus is saying this to us. Whatever you got must be exercised. It must be put into use. Don't sit there with it and ask for more, and you're not using what you have. No. Jesus said, you shall say, you shall speak. It's insignificant. How many times have you felt insignificant? Like of no use. Well, God is after you. He has planted something in your heart and in mine, saying to us, He wants us to use what we have. 1 Corinthians 1:26 to 31. You see your calling, brethren. How not many noble are called, but God has chosen the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. 1 Corinthians 1 from the 26th verse on to verse number 31, to confound the wise. Yes, And he's chosen the things that have nothing, of no significance, to bring to nothing the things that are, that no flesh should glory in his presence. But all the glory, if we are glory, let our glory be in the Lord. Hallelujah. Depending on him to see us through. Lord, increase my faith. He says, what you have, I want you to use it. But notice, please, he used the mustard seed, and then he also gives to us the sycamine or sycamine tree, or the mulberry tree. Well, they tell us concerning the mulberry tree, it takes about 10 years to produce fruit. But when it does so, it produces in great abundance. And the fruit is rich in vitamins, used for jams and jellies. Many will come and be fed. In fact, it produces so many fruits that as people will come and gather, they would, you know, leave, it would be sown to, it would be given to animals because of its abundance. What do we find coming out of that? Well, the mulberry tree symbolizes patience. Notice, please, it would take about 10 years to produce fruit. But it also speaks of abundance, because when it produces, it's so much. Enough and to spare and to the overflowing. It is also said of the tree that it is stable, it's strong. Oh yes, it's able to navigate and stand up against the winds. What do we find? Speaks about stability. It also speaks of fulfillment after 10 years. Yes, here's the fruit, and the fruit is in abundance. You know, usually when you have fruit trees and they're bearing for the first time, they would either bear one or two. And in few cases, it would be an abundance. In few cases, not that they do not, but usually few. And then the second time of bearing, oh, you're going to get more and more fruit. Well, the mulberry is different. What is Jesus saying to us in all this? Well, and with that faith, that little that you got, you got to have patience. Hold. Don't give up. Don't give in. Pretty soon, you're going to bring forth fruit. You've got to be strong. You've got to be steadfast, unmovable. 1 Corinthians 15, 58. Always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. hence for a number of countries in our world, they take the mulberry tree to symbolize. If you dream a mulberry tree, you're going to be prosperous. If you dream you're picking from a mulberry tree, you will be promoted on your job. See? So people hold the tree as very symbolic for things that are positive in their lives. In other countries of the world, they use the mulberry tree and they said, listen, with this abundance, after time, we're going to have famine. So they count it at times as being, it's not a good sign. No, but Jesus, in all that he's saying, that faith, that mulberry tree, the connection being, if you would exercise patience, if you would be steadfast and unmovable, if you're going to hold to my word, which is forever settled in heaven, you will have all that it takes to do my will, to fulfill my purpose, and to bring honor and glory to my name. Hence the reason, as I said earlier, faith is sandwiched between forgiveness and a relationship, a right relationship with Almighty God through sacrifice and service. So Jesus said in Luke chapter 9 and verse number 23, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. That is so important. Service and sacrifice is absolutely important for the child of God, for every one of us. We must be willing to make the necessary sacrifices, spending time in his presence, seeking his face, seeking his hand, yes, but more his face. Oh God, I want to know you. I want to know you, the plan and the purpose for my life. Oh God, search me and know my heart. Try me and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way that leads to everlasting life. Psalm 139. Yes, we want God's will to be done in our lives. Hence the reason, the need to seek him rather than what he has. When we seek him, when we seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, then all these things shall be added unto us. Matthew the 6th chapter and the 33rd verse. So our faith must be on a firm foundation. Now here is what the writer to the Hebrews say to us in Hebrews the 10th chapter. Hebrews chapter 10 from the 22nd verse. Let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith. Yes, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience. In other words, we must be ready and willing to forgive you're offended by others, but be ready and willing to forgive. And our bodies washed with pure water. Verse number 23. Let us hold fast the profession or confession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful that promise. You cannot go wrong in holding and standing with a God who cannot and will not fail. Faith as a grain of mustard seed must be planted. You've got to use what you have, and it's going to be increased. Yes, we are children of Abraham. We dare to believe. Because if we believe, we will see the glory of Almighty God. John chapter 11 and verse number 40. Remember, we are saved by faith. Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. Remember, the just shall live by faith. Romans chapter 1, 16 and 17. Remember, we walk by faith. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse number 7. Remember, we stand by faith. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse number 24. And if we are going to please God, we must exercise faith. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6. For he that cometh to God must believe that God is. That God is who he said he is. And that he is the rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Staying there, God will come true for us. Let's pray. Kind Father, how we thank you for Father, our great example of faith. How we thank you for your precious word. Thank you for Father Abraham, who exercised faith to hope against hope, but was strong in faith, giving you glory. Oh God, today, help us to walk by faith. Help us to stand by faith. Help us to understand that the just shall live by faith. We do not have to understand everything, for faith is a fact, but it's also an oh God, there's some of us who feel so insignificant, so tiny in the walk with you. I pray that we would all exercise that which you have given to us as we present our bodies as living sacrifices unto you. Oh God, that we would understand that your will for us is good, acceptable, and perfect. We bless your name as we continue to serve you in these times. In the name of Jesus the Christ. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. But what about those of you who have never surrendered to His Lordship? What are you waiting on? The Bible tells us, except we repent, we shall all likewise perish. Have you considered your life? If you should die today, are you ready to meet Him, your Creator? Please, don't operate like the fool who says in his heart there is no God. No. God is too gracious to you to be saying that. Why not submit to Him now? By saying after me, please, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I need You. I surrender to You now. Forgive me of all my sins. Come into my life and save me. I confess You as my Savior and as my Lord. And I want to thank You that You are alive and alive forevermore. I praise You for writing my name in Your book of life. Amen. Father, now I thank You for those who have prayed that prayer to receive You into their lives. Show Yourself strong on their behalf. I rebuke every hindrance in their lives that is not causing them to want to fully commit to You. In the name of Jesus, I thank You for freedom now to serve You in spirit and in truth. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And amen. So having prayed that prayer, I know there's some numbers that I want to encourage you to call. Let them know that you've surrendered your life to Jesus Christ and you want some more assistance in this new walk, in this new life. Yes, therefore, if any man be in Christ, He's a new creation. All things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. Praise be unto God. Hallelujah. Well, thank God. Bless His holy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to prepare ourselves for communion at this time. So I want you to get your bread and the wine. I would be reading the scriptures from 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. Then we will bless it. Bless the emblems and partake together. So please prepare yourself to do so now. Praise God. Thank you. want to be reading at this time from 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. I'm just going to be reading a few verses, the 34 verses. I'm just going to be reading a few of them from the 23rd verse. 1 Corinthians chapter 11 from verse number 23. And the word of God reads thus. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he comes. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep or die. And we do not want that. We want to partake worthily. So let's pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you this day for the privilege that you have given to us, Lord, to commune in this setting, to fellowship on this platform. Oh Father, today, first of all, we present ourselves to you, asking you to forgive us of our sins, our transgression, our deceit, our guile. Lord, where we have failed, Lord, where we have failed to forgive our transgressions, in the name of Jesus the Christ, I ask, Father, that blood, the blood of Jesus Christ, that is able to purge our consciences from dead works, to serve the true and living God, that you would purge us, you would forgive us of all our sins, O God, and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Thank you for the blood that is able to do this for us. And now as we partake worthily, we thank you for the blessings that are going to flow. Because, oh God, we understand more than ever before that the price that was paid by our Lord Jesus Christ is so significant, because he loves us with an everlasting love. So we bless you. We bless these emblems today for your honor and for your glory, and to do us good as we continue to walk by faith in the name of the living God, the Son of the living God. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. Well, let's eat together, please. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Shall we drink together, please? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be unto God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. We love you, O God. We praise your name. Yes, let's thank God wherever you are. Thank him, child of God. Lord, we thank you for healing. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for strength. I know you can put the glasses down now. Just give him the praise. Or the cups, whatever you've used today. Father, we thank you. And we bless you. And we adore you. And we glorify your precious and holy name. Great are you, God. Thank you for ministering. You are our Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals us. You are our deliverer. You are our wisdom. You are our righteousness. Thank you, O God, for your grace and for your peace. Thank you that the kingdom of God is not in meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Oh God, thank you that the joy of the Lord is our strength. Thank you for making it good for us and our household. In the name of Jesus the Christ, praise be unto God. Hallelujah. Well, even after we're through, I want you to continue to give him praise, glory, and honor. And that you would go through some of the scriptures today as you fill your heart and your mind with the goodness and with the word of Almighty God. I want to take the time out to tell you thanks as we continue to work together and support the work of Almighty God. In our tithes and offerings, our special offerings, yes, as we continue to give, oh, the work of God continues, and it's in a time like this, God is looking at our hearts. Oh, yes, this is going to change. There's a time and a season for everything. Oh, this pandemic is going to get, we're going to get over it. It's going to get over. Yes, 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 yes. Hallelujah. But have we remained faithful to God? This is very important. Hallelujah. So I want to thank the many of you who continue to give. And those of you who are giving for the first time, thank you. The Bible says as we give, it shall be given unto us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. God is going to give us favor. Luke chapter 6 and verse number 38. So thank you again. And those of you with the hampers, this is the beginning of the month. We want you, please, yes, bring them into the church. Call the office Monday. On Friday, that's the time we still meet. Just 2 days a week, Monday and Friday. Just let them know that you're bringing something. They will be open from 8. We are there from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Mondays and Fridays for this time. Okay? When it changes, we are going to let you know. But thank you. Hallelujah. As we continue to honor him. Well, until we meet again, remember, we are not going under. We have the victory through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because he is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen and amen.
Thank you, Pastor, for the ministry of the word, and thank you, viewers. If you've been blessed by this ministry, then like, share, feel free to subscribe to our various social media platforms. Thank you. Our office hours are on Monday and Friday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Also, if you would like to support us financially, our account information is listed below. Thank you very much for viewing, and we'll see you again next week. Have a blessed week, everyone.
Show me your face. Fill up this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right
now. Big ups
now.
To my peeps.
I can't escape
to my crew.
Being afraid.